What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, hello, my name is Murda Beats, and I'm gonna be your host for today's video. So yeah, last night I went and watched the Avengers Endgame, and let me tell you what, that movie was 10 out of 10. I love that movie. I don't wanna get into spoilers too much, so I don't wanna ruin anything for you guys who didn't watch it, but the way that they sent off Barnacle Boy's arc is just, dude, I was emotional, I'm not gonna lie. Besides all that good stuff, I noticed that the soundtrack was just absolutely awesome. I don't wanna butcher the guy's last name, but Alan, the guy who did most of the sound work for it, was just absolutely amazing. And I heard a lot of stuff in there that I was just like, wow. So I wanted to go through and see if I can turn it into some type of hip hop trap beat. So I'm gonna do my best here to avoid the YouTube copyright system, because if it just hears like any part of the song, I'm sure it'll just get demonetized right away. So I'm gonna change the pitch, but I am gonna link the original song down below for you guys to listen to and go support, of course. Yeah, if you guys do enjoy, please consider subscribing and check me out on Instagram and my other social medias at thecxdy. So, let's just get right into it. Alrighty, guys, so I went ahead and pulled up the sample and I just pitched it down a little bit. It's called He Gave It Away, but let me just say that this man did so good on this entire, the whole thing is amazing. I really hope that Mrs. Alan Silvestri just gave him one of these right after this came out, because he did a masterful job on this. So, let's give this a listen. I like that right there. I think I'm gonna chop that up, see if I can get it on beat. Alrighty, I'm gonna bounce this up to like 160 and kinda see how it keeps. I can't talk, man. So I'm gonna move the BPM up to 160 and just stretch it to fit and kinda just see how it sounds and go from there. Alrighty, so I didn't do anything too crazy with the melody. I kinda just let the presets and the mixers kinda just do the work for me. I added a bit of RC20 retro color, which basically just makes it a little more like harsh, a little bit more crackly. It just makes it feel very vintage. Cut out the low ends with the EQ, super simple, and then added some halftime. So I didn't do anything like super technical or nothing like that. I just wanted to get a good baseline. And I think I got a good vibe I can start working with here. So I'm gonna go ahead and resample that same melody and chop it up and see what I can come up with to give it a little bit more of a bouncy vibe that I can go with like maybe more up-tempo drums. So I ended up kind of scrapping some of the stuff I did and but basically I kept everything the same, like the mixer stuff I showed you, but I just changed the pitch a little bit more. And then I chopped it up and now I have full control over what I can do. So I'm going to record something right now. That was pretty good. So I'm gonna go back in here and just quantize these and kind of mess around with it a little bit just to see if I can come up with something a little bit more cool or something. I don't know. So here's the final chop. I actually came up with the melody. I kept most of the things the same and just added a little bit of tweaks here and there just to make it not boring when it just keeps going over. So like at the end here, you could see I added different notes. And then here, And then here I added another note. And this is how that sounds. So I'm starting out here with a very basic two-step hi-hat pattern, and I'm gonna embellish on this a little bit and add a little bit more flair just to give it more of like that trap feel, just like crazy hi-hats a little bit. But I don't want it to overpower the other sound, so I'm just gonna be very subtle with it. But here's how it sounds right now. Thank you. So I add a little bit of the small rolls to give it that trap feel. And I have it highlighted here in red so you can peep that right now. Yo, I'm seriously so bad at clicking stuff in, like playing it. I don't know if it's the latency like with FL Studio or with like the latency in my brain, but like I'm never on beat with none of this, dude. I always have to go back and quantize stuff. Here's this 808 I brought in and tuned a little bit. And I'm gonna do an 808 pattern here, it's just a basic one. So I'm just going in here and adding just random perks just to give it a little bit more life before I go into the effects and sound effects and stuff like that. And then I'm pretty much gonna wrap it up. Alrighty, for the other eight here, I just brought in the chopped up melody and I just had it play just continuously. Alrighty guys, so that basically wraps it up for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, big shout out to Alan for his just masterful work on this whole entire OST. The soundtrack's amazing. Movie's awesome. Enjoyed it. Yeah. Peace, thank you. Perfect.